When Mother Lets Us Cook by Constance Johnson. Part 2. Waiting Rule. Make your friends wait if there's any delay, but never your omelette, cakes, or souffle, for friends will not spoil, but the other things may. Sweet Omelette. 4 eggs, 3 teaspoonfuls powdered sugar, 1/2 teaspoonful vanilla extract, teaspoonful butter, chafing dish or double boiler, teaspoon, egg beater, spatula, 2 bowls for mixing, fork. Take 2 eggs and separate the whites and yolks. Put the whites in one bowl and the yolks in another. Add to the yolks 2 whole eggs, 3 generous teaspoonfuls of powdered sugar, and 1/2 teaspoonful vanilla. Beat with an egg beater until very light. Put some boiling water in the under pan of your chafing dish or double boiler. A chafing dish is the best, for it is easier to serve the omelet in the dish in which it is cooked, and you cannot do this with an ordinary double boiler. Be sure that the lamp in your chafing dish is lighted. In the upper pan, drop a teaspoonful of butter, and as it melts, spread it over the pan with a spoon, so that the sides as well as the bottom are greased. Whip the 2 remaining whites with an egg beater until very stiff, and mix them with the rest of the eggs, very carefully with a fork. Pour into the buttered pan, cover the pan, and cook it without touching for 15 minutes. Serve at once, in the same pan. If you use a double boiler, loosen the sides of the omelet with a spatula or flexible knife so that it will come away from the pan, fold half of it over the other half, and turn out upon a hot plate. This is enough for 3 people. Cereal cakes. Any cooked cereal, tablespoonful of butter, iron saucepan, turning knife or spatula, mixing bowl. Someday, when there is cooked oatmeal or hominy or rice left over from breakfast, ask your mother to let you make it into a lunch dish. Take a small iron saucepan and put it on the hot part of the stove. It should get very hot. Take the cold cereal in your hands and mold it into little cakes about the size of fish balls. Put a piece of butter as big as a sugar lump into the hot saucepan, and as soon as it is all melted, lay the little cakes into the pan. At the end of 1 minute, lift up one of the cakes with your turning knife, and if the underside has a brown crust on it, turn the cake over. Do the same with each cake until they are all nicely browned on both sides. They should be eaten right away with sugar or maple syrup on them. Pancakes. 1 teaspoonful baking powder, 1 1/2 cups flour, 2 eggs, 1 cup milk, 1 teaspoonful salt, butter, fork, 1 teaspoon, 2 mixing bowls, measuring cup, egg beater, flour sifter, saucepan, spatula, wooden spoon. Take 2 eggs and break them carefully so that the whites and yolks shall be separate, and put the yolks in one bowl, the whites in another. Beat the whites stiff with your egg beater, and then beat the yolks. Sift some flour into your measuring cup until you have 1 1/2 cupfuls. Add 1 teaspoonful of baking powder and 1 teaspoonful of salt. Before doing anything else, put your frying pan on a hot part of the stove. Sift your flour mixture into the bowl with the egg yolks and stir them together with a wooden spoon. Measure 1 cupful of milk and add this to the flour and egg. Stir it in a little at a time and beat the mixture well with the wooden spoon. There must be no lumps in the batter. Last of all, mix in your beaten egg whites carefully with a fork. Put about 1/2 teaspoon of butter into your hot pan, leaving it on the stove. When the butter is melted, pour into the pan 1 tablespoonful of the batter. Spread this out quickly so that the batter in the pan will be very thin, and let the cake cook until it is brown on the underside. The hotter your pan, the quicker the batter will cook, and the better your pancake will be. You can lift up a corner to see if it is done, if you do this carefully with a spatula. When the cake is done on one side, turn it quickly and carefully with the spatula, and brown on the other side. Never turn a cake more than once. It spoils it. When both sides of the cake are done, lift it out of your pan and put it on a hot plate. Make the rest of the cakes in the same way, as rapidly as possible, and serve at once with sugar and butter, or with maple sugar, or maple syrup, or with cream. You may have to add a little butter to your pan if you find it is getting dry. Baking rule. When you bake a small thing, have the oven hot. But for baking big things, cool it off a lot. In a too hot oven, put a pan of water. That will cool it nicely, or at least it oughter. Baked stewed pears. Pears, spices, baking dish. Take some small sickle pears, wash them, and put them whole into a deep dish. Sprinkle each one with a pinch of sugar, a pinch of cinnamon, and a pinch of cloves. Cover the bottom of your dish with an inch of cold water and set in a hot oven to simmer. This usually takes 3 hours. If the water dries off, add a little more. They are done when soft. Serve with cream or milk. You can also use hard green cooking pears, but these must be peeled. Baked potatoes. 6 potatoes, scrubbing brush, fork. Choose 6 potatoes of about the same size and scrub the dark skin well with a scrubbing brush and cold water. Pierce them with a fork. Put the potatoes in a hot oven and cook them with their jackets on for about 1 hour. Try them with a fork in about 3/4 of an hour and see if they are soft. If they are, wrap them in a clean table napkin and serve at once. Baked potatoes are very nice with butter and salt. Some people like them with milk. Baked apples. 6 apples, granulated sugar, butter, cinnamon, 1 cup hot water, apple corer, baking pan, cup, fork. Pick out 6 nice large cooking apples. Greenings are the best. Core them and put them in a pan. Put on top of each as much granulated sugar as you can pinch between your finger and thumb, a pinch of cinnamon, and a bit of butter about the size of 1/2 lump of sugar. Pour about 1 cup of hot water into the pan and set in a moderate oven. It is almost impossible to say how long to leave them in. They are done when they are soft and juicy, probably in about 1/2 hour. Stick a fork into them and try them when you think they are done. Put them in a pretty plate or bowl with all the syrup that has been cooked out of them and serve with cream or milk. They are nice hot or cold. Nest egg. Eggs, salt, pepper, mixing bowl, egg beater, baking bowl, spoon. Take a nice fresh egg and ask the cook to show you how to break it open carefully and separate the white and the yolk so that the yolk will not be broken. Leave the yolk in a half eggshell and let the white fall into a mixing bowl. Add a pinch of salt to the white and beat with an egg beater until it is very stiff. Have ready some little bowl or deep saucer that is pretty enough to put on the table and yet will not break in the oven. Into this dish, pour the stiff beaten white and make a little hole in the middle of the white with a spoon. In this little hollow place, put the yolk, still unbroken. Set the dish in a hot oven and cook for 2 or 3 minutes, or until the white is a little brown and the yolk is firm. Serve right away. There must be a separate dish for each egg. Tapioca pudding. 3 tablespoonfuls pearl tapioca, 1 quart milk, 2 tablespoonfuls sugar, 1 egg, 2 teaspoonfuls vanilla, mixing bowls, tablespoon, teaspoon, baking dish, egg beater. Put 3 tablespoonfuls of pearl tapioca into 1/2 cup of cold water and leave it for 1/2 hour or more. Break an egg into a mixing bowl and beat with an egg beater until it is very light. Add to this 2 tablespoonfuls of granulated sugar and 2 teaspoonfuls of vanilla extract, and mix them all together. Pour over this 1 quart of milk and mix well. Strain the water from the tapioca and add the tapioca to the mixture, and pour the whole into a pretty baking dish of some sort. Bake for 1 hour in a moderate oven. Serve cold in the same dish with sugar and cream or milk. This is enough for 6 people. Spoonfuls and cupfuls. Fill to a level spoon or cup, unless you're told to heap it up. Scalloped fish. Cold fish, butter, flour, milk, pepper, salt, breadcrumbs, saucepan, fork, spoons, baking dish. Take some cold fish, say enough to make 1 pint, and pick it to pieces with a silver fork. Be sure to take out every bone. Make a cream sauce, as you have learned to do, with 1 tablespoonful of flour, 1 tablespoonful of butter, and 1 cup of milk. Use a saucepan or double boiler, and be careful not to let it burn. Add 1 teaspoonful of salt and a little pepper. Put your fish into the saucepan with the sauce, mix it all up well, and take from the stove. Take a baking dish and butter the sides and bottom carefully. Turn the fish into the baking dish. Have ready about 1/2 cup of stale breadcrumbs, add to them a pinch of salt and a smaller pinch of pepper, mix them all up, and sprinkle over the fish. Drop some very small bits of butter on the top, and put the dish in a pretty hot oven to brown. This should take about 15 minutes, but it might take less or more, according to the heat of the oven. Take the fish out when the top is brown, and serve right away. This can be baked in little dishes or in large shells. Rice pudding. 4 tablespoons rice, 4 tablespoons sugar, nutmeg, 1 quart milk, mixing bowl, strainer or sieve, enamel baking dish. Take 4 tablespoonfuls of rice, pick out all the specks and dried kernels, and wash it by putting it in a strainer or sieve and letting clean, cold water run over it. Put the washed rice into a bowl and add 4 tablespoonfuls of granulated sugar. Pour over the rice 1 quart of good milk. Turn the mixture into a baking dish. The pudding will be creamier if you use an enameled metal one, but you can use china. Grate over the top some nutmeg and set the dish in a moderate oven. Cook for about 2 hours. From time to time, as the pudding begins to get brown on top, stir down the top crust. Do this twice. When the rice is thoroughly soft, it is done. Rice pudding is better served quite cold. If you like raisins, get some of the seedless kind. Measure about 2 tablespoonfuls and soak them in boiling water for 5 minutes. Drain off the water and stir them into the pudding before you put it into the oven. The straw test. With a straw, I pierce my cake when I think it's cooked enough. If the straw gets sticky rough, I must longer bake. If it comes out clean and neat, then the cake is fit to eat. Cup custard for 3. 2 eggs, granulated sugar, salt, nutmeg, hot water, 1 pint milk, egg beater, saucepan, grater, baking dishes, baking pan, mixing bowl, spoon. Break 2 eggs carefully into a bowl and beat with an egg beater for 3 minutes. Add 1/4 teaspoonful of salt and 2 heaping tablespoonfuls of granulated sugar. Beat with a spoon for 2 minutes. Heat 1 pint of milk in a saucepan until it is very hot but not boiling, and mix with the egg and sugar, beating it again for a minute with your spoon. Take 3 small dishes, or 1 large one, that will be pretty and yet stand baking, and pour the mixture in. Grate a little nutmeg over the top. Put the baking dishes into a pan, and put the pan into a moderately hot oven. Before you shut the oven door, pour some hot water into the pan carefully, so that none of it will get into the custards. the water should come up about halfway to the top of the custard cups. Cook until the custards are firm in the middle and brown on top. If you use the little cups or dishes, this should take about half an hour. The larger dish will take longer. Use the straw test. Take them out of the pan and set them where they will cool. Serve them very cold. If you have no pretty dish, fold a clean table napkin so that it will be the width of the dish, lay it around the dish, and pin it together. Chicken custard. 1 cup thick chicken stock. 1 cup cream or milk. Yolks of 3 eggs. 1 teaspoonful salt. Measuring cup, custard cups, double boiler, egg beater, teaspoon, bowl. Someday, when the cook has some good, rich chicken stock in the house, measure out 1 cupful and put it in the top part of a double boiler. Add to it 1 cup of cream, or if you have no cream, 1 cupful of milk into which you have stirred 1 teaspoonful of melted butter. The cream or milk must be absolutely fresh, or your custard will curdle. Put your pan on the stove and cook your milk and stock until it begins to smoke. Do not let it come to a boil. While this is cooking, break open 3 eggs carefully and separate the whites and yolks. The whites can be put away in the ice box for future use. Beat the yolks with an egg beater until they are stiff. When your milk and chicken is ready, take it from the stove and add the beaten egg yolks and 1 teaspoonful of salt. Mix well with a spoon. Put the pan into the double boiler and set it on a hot part of the stove. Cook until the mixture begins to get thick. Pour it into custard cups and set in a cold place to get hard and cold. Serve cold. This ought to be enough for 5 people. It is nice for a hearty supper or lunch dish, also to serve to invalids. Brown Betty. 6 cooking apples, 1/2 cup molasses, 1/2 cup cold water, 4 tablespoonfuls brown sugar, butter, breadcrumbs, apple corer, measuring cup, baking dish, knife. Take 6 large tart apples, core them and peel them, and cut them into small slices. Take a baking dish, butter the inside, and cover the bottom with 1 layer of apple slices. Sprinkle a layer of breadcrumbs over the apple, then lay more apple over the crumbs, and so on until you have used all the apple. There must be crumbs on top. Measure 1/2 cupful of black molasses and 1/2 cupful of cold water. Add to this 4 tablespoonfuls of brown sugar and stir until the sugar is dissolved. Pour the mixture over the apple and crumbs and drop 4 little bits of butter on top of all. Put the dish in a moderate oven for about 3/4 of an hour, or until it is nicely browned on top and the apples are soft. Try them with a fork. Serve hot with cream or a hard sauce. End of part 2.